Oj!
Skulle du upp dig? Ja.
It's Korn.
Okay, sorry.
Blind. I'm blind. No. No? You don't listen to Korn?
Not much. Just the ones on the radio.
Okay, okay. Like...
Freak Unleashed.
Freak Unleashed, yes.
Yeah.
Okay, okay. Well, that was Blind from the first Korn album.
Okay.
You haven't heard that? There's a little ride. It's like...
No.
Okay, well, all right. Are you ready? Welcome everyone, good morning and welcome to Mel Morning number 6.
Wow.
Do you have your coffee ready?
Yes.
Sixth episode, we've been doing good, I think. You're
getting
into it.
Warmer clothes.
You're getting warm in your clothes, yes, exactly.
My clothes are getting warmer?
Yes, yes, yes. That's actually the expression in Swedish, by the way. But yeah, we're getting into this and people are noticing. And that you're also getting more and more into it. A lot of wives are commenting now.
Yeah.
And a lot of husbands of wives are commenting as well, saying that they're incredibly happy about this show. Because the women that might not necessarily be into metal, they have finally had something common to watch. And, you know, finally maybe getting their wives and
but
women's
into metal.
I know, but, you know, it's easier for women to kind of, you know...
Talk to other women.
I don't know, but no, I mean, but it's more like, you know, husbands and wives, that, you know, the married couples,
yeah.
They can relate.
So, I think I'm not reading the comments.
No.
But I read the emails.
Yes, the emails.
Mostly very nice, positive words.
Yes.
That I'm being in the show.
Yes, exactly. And I mean, it's only every other week, so it's yeah. Not that often or anything.
I mean, the ones that doesn't like it, they get to see Swola.
Exactly, or they can watch Will It Chug,
you know, or it's, anything else.
There are choices. You can make a choice in life. How about that? We give you the choices.
Yes.
And
there are other YouTube channels to
there
watch
are
too.
Other, we have to talk about.
I have a friend.
We have to talk about Dean and Claire.
Yes.
Who did Four Levels of Mel with us?
Yeah.
Go check that out. See if I can remember to put a link here. But I will probably recognize this during the premiere when I'm sitting there like, oh shit, I should have posted in the link. And yes, that's how it's gonna work. You had a friend?
I also have a YouTube friend.
Oh.
Yes, he's called Jamie Slays. Do you know Jamie Slays?
Jamie Slays. He's recently, I do know him, and he's an excellent guitar YouTuber.
And also a solar artist.
Yes, and he just reached 100,000 subscribers.
Yes, is he there yet?
I don't know. No, he will be there. Han kommer där när vi.
Yes. Congratulations.
So congratulations. You simp.
Jamie.
He's trying to get to me by going through Louise. No, I'm just kidding. Jamie, congratulations.
Well done.
Just keep on doing the same shit that you're doing and you'll be fine. He's doing a really good job. I'm actually kind of half excited today because we're going to talk about nu metal.
Half excited?
Yes. You know, nu metal is fun because a lot of people hated nu metal back when it became a thing.
Yeah.
And that's why I like to discuss it, because it just brings out the worst in a lot of people. Do you have
How did it come to you? Like, how did you respond to it? when you first heard some new metal.
With mixed emotions, yeah. I must say. Because I was listening to Pantera and, you know, Bolt Thrower, death metal, like really heavy shit. You know, and out came Korn, which are...
Maybe somewhere
borderline
between.
Somewhere else. Yeah. You know, a lot of the new metal came from kind of like rap metal.
Yeah.
You know, and rap metal...
Hon äter sladdar.
Nej! Don't eat my cables! Holy shit, that
he's eating cables.
That's also a strömkabel. Don't eat my cables. Nej!
That's also a strömkabel. You shouldn't eat the strömkabel.
Don't eat the strömkabel, it's completely
it's
dangerous.
It's really bad.
It's like the high voltage cable. No, but speaking about rap metal, which was a thing that came earlier, actually, I just have to mention Clawfinger, that is Jocke Skog.
Yeah.
Good friend of mine, and also lending bass in Feared, and he produced a mix.
They must have been early.
Oh yeah, like type. Early 90s yes. They started and became a thing. This song is from like 2000, I just had to play it because it's such a f***ing banger of a song. So from the rap metal, I think when Korn and bands like Deftones came about, it was just completely different. We had 90s metal and grunge came along and, you know, kind of switched everything up, and a lot of people say that grunge killed metal. Then nu metal came along and was very alternative. I mean, if you listen to Korn, it was just so different. It was really hard to categorize because, I mean, this type of singing, which is not really singing, it's almost him talking, almost like rap because it's talking. They were... or wore like baggy clothes, skate clothing, and you know, it's a little hard to categorize.
I remember when they came, like, they were so big. I mean, they were everywhere.
Yeah, they exploded afterwards. Because they were one of the bigger first different bands.
I mean, not only with metal fans.
No, also one of the few bands that no one sounds like them. I mean, no one sounds like Jonathan Davis, for instance, the singer. And it's just such a distinctive sound. Even though they were one of the first nu metal bands, you can't also call them nu metal because it's just so different from the nu metal that became nu metal afterwards.
Yeah.
Deftones? Remember Deftones?
Yeah.
I remember when this video came on MTV and I was like, holy shit, that guitar tone. What? It's so hard because he's singing clean and, you know, screaming at the same time. How is that possible? No, but just very uncommon that the singer did so many different things.
Yeah.
You know, obviously, like Pantera, you could sing both growl and scream and sing clean, but it's this, it's very alternative, almost pop in a way, in the way that they sing. And this guitar tone, by the way. Listen to that, holy shit. So it's, you know, very often no guitar solos. A lot of 7-string guitars. Nu metal kind of adopted the 7-string guitar.
Is that where you put on the extra lower?
You put on a lower extra string, which
so
is also
darker.
Yes, it's lower tune, which Korn was all about. They were one of the first 7-string bands.
Yeah.
And which is weird because obviously you can just take a 6-string guitar and tune it down. If you're not going to solo that much, you're not really...
You don't need the...
not the extra string, exactly. So very common that you didn't hear any guitar solos, which is really weird coming from the metal that was all about like blazing solos and you know, guitar heroes and whatnot. Now came like the anti-heroes, where you know,
maybe they wanted to get into the larger audience that
maybe
not really appreciates guitar solos.
But at the time, this wasn't meant to be mainstream.
How do you know that? Maybe they, it was exactly that they wanted.
I don't know.
But it's really good.
I also wanted to bring in Cold Chamber, because Cold Chamber is a. They were the first that, or one of the first that maybe wore like makeup and a little bit more emo looking.
Yeah.
And
you see this.
Yeah, a little, you know, dressing up like clowns a little bit. Go ahead. But very good guitar tone, rhythm tone, and look, like, a little freakish.
Yeah, a little bit Slipknot-y.
Yeah.
So I would guess Slipknot is also a new metal?
We're getting there, we're getting to Slipknot, but I think nu metal just broke so many rules that the real metal fans just hated it. Like, they won't be able to adapt.
I would guess rap.
Oh yeah, yeah. Like, it was, you know, because metal fans are very, they care about their music.
Yeah.
And when this came, it was really like, oh no, don't touch my metal.
Oh yeah, yeah.
And people went fucking apeshit about it, and it became like two camps where it was easy to hate on nu metal because it was sort of dorky and rappy and poppy and,
yeah,
and all. Another very significant band, Limp Bizkit.
Yeah.
Which was really rap metal.
Very rap metal.
And I must say, Limp Bizkit are f***ing awesome. I'm not afraid to say it. They were mixing it so well. The rap, the heavy guitars, good choruses, and even like the melodic parts. Like, it's a very good mixture of everything. And I can definitely hear how this attracted a lot of people from outside the metal genre to actually listen to
maybe
metal.
Rap people.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Or like just bringing them together.
Yeah.
I mean, then people hate Fred Durst a lot, but I think it's pretty fun.
I mean, he was such a character.
He was a character. And
back in
then
the
you have Wes Borland, who's he's a great guitar player.
With a cap, red cap.
And it just looks this like throwing signs and all that. Like, it's fun, man. It's almost like a caricature of the genre a little bit. But dude, I like this album, Significant Other. That was a great album.
I would guess, like, at the same time with Linkin Park.
Yes.
Limp Bizkit, it was Linkin Park as well.
Yes. So
melodic,
now we're like end 90s, right?
Yeah.
Where it, you know, we got Cold Chamber, we got a lot of these type of bands. Then came a band called Slipknot.
Yes.
And Slipknot, in my opinion, killed nu metal a little bit.
Weren't you like a Slipknot fan?
Oh, I love Slipknot.
Yeah.
Slipknot are great. And I remember when this album came out, it was such a breath of fresh air because a lot of bands, you know, even Metallica, started with, you know, Load and, you know, they ventured into a more mainstream. I think a lot of bands tried to go mainstream at the end 90s because they didn't identify and didn't know what they wanted to sound like. So we saw a lot of bands that started to sound different, but then Slipknot came along and just took a huge dump on everyone. And it's still nu metal, but brutal as So I think after this, nu metal kind of became less popular, but there were more other bands that took over and just became incredibly big, like Linkin Park, for instance.
I mean, I remember that Linkin Park, the piano in the beginning was like always, not this song, but you know, the one with the piano in the start.
Exactly. Linkin Park.
You must hate this.
You must hate this.
Yes.
You know why I don't like it? Because it's overplayed. I just heard it all over the place.
Yeah.
And I remember I was probably not liking this a lot.
No.
But I also didn't listen to it because I was way into death metal.
Yeah.
I just didn't pay attention to a lot of it. I heard it on radio.
But,
what the hell is this?
This is very soft and
it's very
like
soft
pop.
And then the rap.
Yeah.
I understand why people like it. It's very, very mainstream. And you have to give them cred because this type of music, it's a gateway for a lot of people to start listening to metal.
I mean, this is still today.
Oh, very relevant.
Many bands playing like this.
I think Linkin Park is the most listened to band on Spotify.
Really?
It's such a big band.
I didn't know that.
And obviously, since his passing as well, it became a lot bigger and all that. But I also have to mention Papa Roach. Do you remember those?
Yeah.
Yeah. Which is more like, you know, happier nu metal. Oh, they censored.
Did they?
Yeah, did you hear it?
No. Oh yeah, give up.
Okay, but yeah.
In Swedish radio, we hear the word.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, this is so far off nu metal. This is like the complete, like if you take Korn, they're over here, way over here. Cockroach is way over here.
Yeah. Wasn't it all about like mixing genres as well?
Yes.
Like giving rap into the metal.
Yeah. No, they're not afraid
singing.
To do anything.
Yeah.
That was, I think, this part of the success of them though.
Yeah.
Just like it was this mix and matching of everything, and it almost became a competition of making a new genre.
Yeah.
You know, okay, we have to make. Can we incorporate like a saxophone into this, or can we do this and make it saxophone, numel or whatever? Yeah. So people got really creative.
Well. Yeah.
And we got a lot of really cool bands coming out of that.
Yeah.
We POD, and I also want to listen to this. Because obviously this is what it's all about.
Burberding!
Burberding!
And the masks and stuff.
Yeah, exactly. I just remember at the time when I was playing with Subside in Stockholm.
Yeah.
There were so many bands that sounded like this.
I remember that.
All the other bands in Stockholm sounded like this, and you know, really loved nu metal. So there were a lot of nu metal bands in the smaller scene in Stockholm that we played with. And I would say that our band probably borrowed a slight bit as well from nu metal. I mean, I can't say I can't say for sure that Korn definitely influenced what I wrote a little bit back in the day. But you know, for me, guitar solos was always important. So I, you know, always had guitar solo.
Yeah,
for sure. It's what makes a song, you know, in my opinion. Not everyone thinks that, but I do. It's just a classic metal. You know, I'm used to it.
You're entitled to that opinion.
Of course.
I mean, for me, a guitar solo isn't the most important, especially if the solo isn't great.
How dare you?
But a bad solo can ruin a song.
Yeah, exactly.
As well.
Yeah. In every metal morning, we also listen to a newer nu metal band.
Yes.
And we're going to check out a band called Tala.
Tala?
Tala. It's the son of Mike Portnoy, the drummer of Dream Theater.
Oh, yeah.
He formed up a band, and they sound like this. This is from 2020.
Hear similarities?
Yes, for sure.
To
even
the other bands we've listened to,
and also a little bit of djent.
Yeah,
a little bit. I like this. This sounds like nu metal.
It's very.
Oh, there's. Shaka waka waka shaka maka ho. Shaka maka to maka haka to. Shaka shaka laka paka paka ta. Yeah, it's definitely not jam. This is new metal.
Yeah.
I like this.
It sounds
very current.
Yeah.
But that was cool. I like this. Tala, everyone.
It's good.
It's good, man.
But I wouldn't put it on myself.
You wouldn't listen to it on your way to the bus?
No.
Okay.
I mean, it's very well done. I mean, the sound was great.
Yep.
But
I can see myself listening to this.
I'm in another genre right now.
Which genre are you in right now?
Like, progressive stuff.
Progressive metal.
Yeah.
We'll cover progressive metal pretty soon. We're saving it because, you know, that's a big one for us, obviously. Progressive metal.
I mean, we need to prepare ourselves.
Yes, exactly. Anyway, that was nu metal. I think nu metal was very important for metal because it brought a lot of audience into metal. So
yeah.
I don't think you can really hate on nu metal. It's why we're at the point where we are at today. I think it opened up a lot of minds, a lot of bands. And people became more open-minded. While back in the day, it was more about being a little bit true, maybe. It took away a little bit of the seriousness of the whole genre, I think. Which was probably what was needed.
I guess it opened up to society as well. I mean, at the start, do you remember the Wasp thing? You know, with the TV shows and stuff, that metal would be dangerous or...
And evil,
I don't know,
and satanic.
What. Yeah.
And, yeah.
And everything like that. And maybe this helped bring it into the larger arena. Not for just underground people that were metal people. It's just...
Well, maybe it made metal more accepted.
Yeah.
Because it was more borderline not metal.
I think
metal.
So.
It's becoming more and more pop. More and more mainstream. I don't think that's a bad thing.
No. I think it's...
I mean, if it brings more people into metal...
Yes.
I mean, that's good, right?
It is.
Yeah, exactly.
more people need to understand metal.
What the dog doing?
Sorry. All right, that was Nu Metal for you right there. How about that? Dude, Nu Metal makes me happy. I actually, not the other day, but like a couple of months ago, I actually put on the Limp Bizkit album again after not listening to it for like 20 years. It's actually a lot of fun to listen
to.
You
were like...
The production is
rolling.
Did it all for the dookie.
Rolling.
So you can take the kookie and stick it up your yeah. I mean, it has an incredible sound to the album. I really like the production on that album. But yeah, that was Nu Metal for you right there. That was fun. All right. Today the family is going to Gröna Lund. Say ja! We're going to Gröna Lund, which is a theme park in Stockholm. The kids have been in the office with us for the past 2 days, so it's a good little break. Go for a theme park. We're gonna have so much fun. It's gonna be cool. Fortunately for us, it's on the hottest day of Sweden that we're here. It's gonna be 32 degrees. That's basically like 90 degrees Fahrenheit. It's hot for us, okay? We're Swedes. It's like putting a penguin in Florida, okay? So right now we're being lobbied around because restrictions, obviously. My kids are hyped, excited. It's gonna be fun. First thing I found, some cool gear. We have all of these vintage stuff, and then a Line 6 spider. A little too big. Okay, Chevy. The funny house. So funny. Funny. My daughter going for the tunnel of love. Drop my glasses. Okay? No kidding about that. La 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 la. Hey, man. Okay, well, you're okay. Whee! Someone's happy. Oh, stanna nu. Stanna. Yo.
Så
mycket. Okay, nu får du gå bara på den. All right. Kids are happy. That's what's important. Really, really hot. There's just something about having a hot coffee when it's 32 degrees. K kids are happy and unhappy. Parents are
tired,
exhausted. Our son is gone. I can't see him. I think we lost one. Well,
there you go.
There's always a casualty. That's how it is. My daughter's up there somewhere. I don't know where. I recognize the scream. Okay. 5.5 hours of theme park. It says it's 36 degrees now. We're done. We're done. Are the kids happy in Iglada? Dead.
Finished.
That means success. So there you go. Adventures with Ola and the family. Goodbye. All right, question of the day, where me and Louise talk about very, very deep things and life in general. And question from Joshua Jin: why do you have long hair? Why not cut it? Why
is
do you have long
for
hair?
For me or for you?
No, it's obviously for you.
For me, it's. I mean, it grows so fast. You couldn't imagine. So if I get my hair a short haircut, it will only grow back again. And yeah, and you?
I don't think the question was for me. It probably was for me. I keep my long hair because having short hair when playing live sucks.
I mean, you have cut it up a couple of times.
Yeah, yeah. I've had long hair a couple of times and then cut it off. And, you know, usually the first reaction is that I regret cutting it off. now I had it long for probably over 10 years.
Yeah, it's been a while now, this time.
And, I mean, I wouldn't mind cutting the hair. To be honest, I would probably be cutting my hair if it wasn't for me playing live. If you have short hair playing live, you have to mosh so much to make it matter. If you have long hair, you can just
To have longer beard if you have shorter hair.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. But if you have long hair, you can always do this and be like, you know,
hide.
Do a little nodding like this and it looks like you're doing a lot. But if you don't have any hair, you have to fucking mosh a lot to make it matter.
Isn't it also a bit like you're a YouTuber now and this is your image?
Yeah, a little bit.
I mean, if you would cut your hair,
I would lose all the subscribers.
Some
like half.
Other Ola, the short haired Ola.
Exactly.
Who's that?
Exactly.
You're not Jesus anymore.
Exactly. It will be a problem. When will that day come? Maybe at like 1 million subscribers. How about that? I cut my hair.
Okay, is that a bet or?
Let's just leave that, leave the lid on. For that one, but that would be a thing maybe. Next question, Dan Kish. Hi Ola and Luis, my girlfriend of 16 years and I are getting married in June. Any tips for newlyweds? Also, could you shout out my lovely fiance? Her name is Sarah. She surprised me with my first solo guitar recently too.
Great work, what? Sarah.
You never bought me a guitar.
Oh my God, why would I buy you a guitar? Yeah. Like put it here among the others?
Maybe that could be a thing, like a surprise thing. Just put a guitar from nowhere and just put it in my rack over here.
Yeah,
and I'll be just
like,
surprised.
What is this?
That's a very nice fiance right there.
That's
Sarah,
nice. Yes.
Just great taste in guitar, let's say. Tips for newlyweds?
Don't get married too soon.
I think I had this question in an FAQ.
Okay.
But I actually said exactly that.
Yeah.
Like, if you have any ghosts or something in your closet, you better
bring them out
before you actually get married.
I mean, get to know each other very well and everything will go fine.
Also, a good test is just to give your wife or the husband or the guy or the girl, your partner, a really, really slow internet connection and see how they react.
Okay.
I think that will show what type
the
of person.
The real you.
Yeah, the real you. Just download a JPEG file and see how the person will react. I think that's a good
test.
Did
you do that to me?
No, I did not because we had better internet. But I don't know. I think try and have fun together, obviously.
That's a good advice there.
have a lot of the intercourse. And, fuck, I don't know.
Can I say something? I mean, getting married shouldn't be a difference from your relationship before getting married, okay?
Yes, exactly.
Just keep on going. Why did you get together in the first place?
Why do you have to get married in the first place?
You don't have to.
No, exactly.
But if you want to. For me, our wedding day was the best day of my life.
But when our kids were born?
I mean, when our daughter was born, that was the worst day of my life.
That's true.
Ever.
Not as our daughter being the worst thing that happened.
No, not that she
But it was a shit day. Let's just say that.
That was the worst day of my life.
A difficult day.
Yes, and I think the first baby was more like confusing and you didn't really know what to expect and stuff like that. It was just very new.
Yeah, for sure.
So I wouldn't say that to be my best day either.
Okay.
But the wedding day was my best day.
It was a good day.
It was just, everything was just right.
Yeah.
And we were happy. We had a lot of friends at the wedding. We were dancing.
We're having a great time listening to old 90s techno and like, you know, childhood music.
And everybody partying and, you know.
And after the wedding and the party, we went back, we brought everyone over to our place, our apartment. In the middle of the night, just to, you know, continue the party.
I think we had some sausages or something.
Oh, yeah, so eating sausages in the middle of the night, something like that. Yeah, it was a great day.
Vikning.
Vikning, yeah, exactly. Like after party food or something like that.
When you get hungry again.
Yeah, exactly.
After partying for hours.
I mean, but you can have a good party without getting married, just saying.
You could, but that's... Sometimes you
need
to have a reason to have a big party.
Yeah, I agree.
And to get dressed up with a wedding dress, I mean, who doesn't want to do that?
I wish there were something more for extravagant the for the men in that case. I mean, the woman gets to be like the most, like the center of attention at the wedding. I mean, the man is not the center of attention.
No.
It's the women that are, the future wife that is the center of attention.
Yeah.
So it is maybe a little bit more for the woman in that sense, even though it's not. But
I would think that more women dreams about their future wedding than men.
Like a perfect wedding.
Guess.
Than the men. The men just tags along a little bit.
But this was actually a question about the marriage.
A tip. Yes. Have sex. Did I say that? Yes, I did. Be open and honest. I think being open and honest and just try and... Have fun. If you feel like you're working a lot, plan time together. You know, go out and eat, and we do that a lot. We go out on dates, basically. I mean, not forcing, but forcing a date is not a bad thing.
No.
Just saying.
Just spend time together.
Yeah.
Take care of each other.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's an answer.
That is an answer. You're completely right. Ola and Louise tasting shit.
Yeah.
Today we got a package from Drew and Erin, all the way from across the globe, from the US of A. They sent us this. Did you put this all nice and nice? No? And they sent us a video. So we're gonna watch the video together.
Can we say hi to Ola and Louise?
Oh, they have a dog.
It's a dog, look.
Hey Ola, hey Louise, hope y'all are doing well. We sent y'all a box of goodies and chocolates and all from either Arkansas or here in America. Yeah, we hope y'all are doing well. We really love the new show that y'all are doing on Sundays. I think if you had a question for them, what would it be?
Oh, you put me on the spot. Like for the show?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I would think like relationship-y things. So like touring while in a relationship or married or how you handle kids and all that kind of stuff, because there are people who are married with kids who watch your show and who are musicians. So.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I would probably ask. No idea.
Put yourself on the spot.
When are y'all getting a dog?
Oh yeah, that's good.
Or
a cat.
Or a cat.
Or a snake.
Hope y'all enjoy the chocolate and talk to y'all later.
Bye.
Thank you so much. That was Drew and Erin. Very nice of you. Just to answer the question, we're getting a dog. Done. Anyways, we got all of this candy from Arkansas. Shit, they know I like chocolate, so they only sent chocolate, I think. Okay, let's try these first, the Kaya. Cameroon. Isn't that a country?
What's the other one says Uganda, so...
So I'm not sure they're completely for Arkansas, just saying,
Maybe
but it's
the,
okay.
The beans were...
Oh, look at this.
Brought up there.
Oh, unfortunately it's cracked, but look, it's like a pattern or something.
Is that thumb enough for that?
I just don't understand what it is. It's like a very elastic plastic for some reason. All right. Oh, very powderish. Okay, I don't know.
Can I eat that whole piece?
Hmm. It's grainy.
It is.
Like a lot of American chocolate, but...
It is grainy, but...
The taste is good.
Yeah.
Tastes very Cameroon. I think it was good. I'll eat that. No problem. That's great.
You took a big bite.
I took the biggest bite. Okay, let's do that. Sea Arkansas sea and salt caramel. Artisan. What is artisan? Why are... Okay.
The package maybe wasn't the best.
5 out of 10 when it comes to the package, just saying. Okay, this, Arkansas sea salt and caramel.
I just wanted to read what was inside. 10 facts about Arkansas and stuff like that.
The top 10 cities in Arkansas. Little Rock, 200,000 people. Not that big for a state.
I like this.
Fort Smith, Fayetteville, Springdale, North Little Rock. Small cities for a state, must say. I'm gonna try these now. These are s'mores. I'm not sure if you're supposed to eat them in a certain way. Like, do I put them in cream, or do I put them in milk, or...
The Graham crackers. That's a s'more.
Okay, so this is a s'more right here. It's broken, but it looks good. Okay, that's a little bit weird. Okay, marshmallow, milk chocolate, and cracker.
I really like this.
You can have these. Hey, we're gonna test other things, you know?
Okay.
Then we have our Reese's Big Cups with pretzels.
Oh yeah?
We had a big discussion not too long ago in my Discord server, and I made a lot of people surprised that I'm not a fan of pretzels.
Okay.
You know, salty pretzels.
Yeah.
But apparently in the US, they eat it like in cheese sauce and shit like that. So they dip it in a lot of shit. Okay, I'm just gonna eat this.
Very soft. Is it peanuts?
Very salty.
Very salty.
Holy shit. That's a salt fest right there. All right.
I mean, the taste is nice, but it's very salty.
Great taste.
So what are these?
Then there's some Girardelli squares. And there's raspberry, sea salt, and milk chocolate. Obviously, I'm going for the milk chocolate, okay? I'm all in with the milk chocolate guy.
I'm going for the raspberry stuff.
All right. You know, it's about the milk chocolate. That's where I judge American people.
Is it grainy or not?
Is it grainy? Is it shitty? You don't know.
It's not grainy.
It's not shitty.
You know, it has a raspberry jam in it.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you can see that, but... not maybe my favorite.
In my opinion, don't mix colored stuff with chocolate. Okay, what was your favorite among all these?
Would you guess?
Oh, the s'mores. This was above par when it comes to American chocolate. Let's just say that. I'm being completely honest. Sorry, Drew and Aaron. But, you know, this is a very touchy subject for me. And, you know, when I'm talking milk chocolate, I like to be serious about it. It's super important. I like this. I could eat this on a rainy day. No problem. There you go. Thank you so much to Drew and Aaron for these lovely, lovely sweets that we're going to continue to eat. And back to you, Luis. And Ola. All right, that was it. Shit, I feel like I've been sitting like way too like this for this video. I'm sorry. That's better posture. Okay, you did it last time, I'll do it this time, okay?
Yes, thank you.
Awesome. That was it for Mel Morning for this week. Thank you so much for watching. And as always, my beautiful, beautiful wife, Louise, at my side. And...
The dog.
The little dog. That we just found out likes to chew on cables. But... Did you see that I said a firm no?
Hon äter sladdar.
Nej! Don't eat my cables! That was it. Basically. That's how you train dogs, okay? So, thank you so much for watching, guys. If you wouldn't mind, please do not unsubscribe. And I'll see you next time. Bye!
Bye!